Mark Wahlberg's new shtick must be to just being like big American, like what's out at the moment? Horizon, no, what the fuck? Deep Water Horizon. True Story American Tales. Now, I read Patriots today and I was like, this probably ain't gonna interest me
Why are
as
you
a
laughing?
non-American.
It's just, I
It's
look
about the
like a
Boston
clown.
bombings,
What's
right?
the color?
I'm basically a crossing guard. You got my whistle, my stop sign?
Come here a kiss.
I love you.
I love you.
Yeah.
Hey,
Sorry,
how many
I'm
times you run
interested.
this thing?
Boston 18, 43 overall.
That's impressive, boss.
I mean, everyone knows how what the story goes. Like, based on true events. From the, it's still. Oh my God! They're just piling them out and. I haven't seen Deadpool Horizon, but it's supposed to be great. So, and I mean, I haven't seen the other one either. I kind of want to go back and watch that the army one. I can't remember. It was just literally on the screen. That's supposed to be great. Deadpool Horizon is supposed to be great. So maybe I need to start getting on board with all these Mark Wahlberg team up movies with I can't remember the director's name. It'll stay here in a minute, guys. Sure, it gives you the came back. Oh, J.K. Simmons. I missed him there for a second. Peter Berg! Peter Berg! So I might want to get. Music by Trent Reznor. Okay. I want to get on board with this whole Peter Berg, Mark Wahlberg fucking team up, do a million movies based on true story things that apparently are all great. So, what is it? Oh, it's Lone Survivor. That's it. I remember it now. I need to go back and watch Lone Survivor. And if I get a chance, I should go to the cinema. Because Deep Water, that's what it's called, right? I don't wanna be calling it the wrong movie. Can I just flick through here for Deep Water Horizon? Okay, thank you. Because I'm gonna see that. Because it's supposed to be great. As for the trailer, double thumbs up. It gives you the whole setup. So it's obviously gonna follow Mark Wahlberg's character as you go through it with him. John Goodman's in there. I don't know. It's like the organizer or someone, I suppose. J.K. Simmons is a cop or something. I probably. Sure. If it's simply judging upon the pedigree involved, and apparently, if everything's to be judged, apparently it's they have this great partnership going. So maybe that's his thing there. Peter Berg, Mark Wahlberg, just shit out. What do they keep? American hero subgenre. Films, whatever you want to call it. I know there's probably people in the comments. Let's look, because you know shit like this is always. Well, someone says, does Mark Wahlberg only do real life tragedy movies now? Which that's what I was gonna say. I don't want to say this comes. I just see why. I don't want to sound awfully rude. And I not, see this is what I was looking for. I don't want to sound awfully rude. I know this will come as that, but just don't see why this is a movie. It wasn't even that long ago. It just seems disrespectful. Now, it's long enough. Okay. Now, the question a lot of people, because you've had more real life movies start up recently where they're just putting them out, because up until a while ago, it would be like, oh, based on true story, when did it happen? It happened like 15, 20 years ago. Now you've got stuff happening with documentaries coming out where the court cases are still happening and stuff like that. See Netflix, and you've got movies about people coming out who are still alive. So, and this is always a dilemma factor. You had what Straight Outta Compton, which I love, but one of the reasons I put it down is because I was like, well, it tells a very positive light of them mostly. And how much different would that movie have been if everyone involved in that story had been dead and there was no what nothing to weigh it down from, just telling you as it needs to be. So I understand that comment, but at the same time, Does it need to exist? Yeah, people like to watch these movies, and they don't like to watch it as a, like, 2012 end of the world, like, go in there, mindless fun. People like to watch these movies, especially, as I was saying, American hero movies, because people like to go watch these movies, and they like to celebrate the people involved for the good work they did. And if you're going to follow Mark Wahlberg, they're probably going to have him, what, be involved in the capture, or looking for the dude, or, like... He probably like saves a bunch of lives, helps save people's lives on the day. So, do people need to see the movie? Sure, they need to see the movie. It's a way to celebrate the heroes that were involved in dark events. And I don't see why there's any need, any reason why you can't do that. So, Patriots Day, I like it. It looks great. Peter Berg movie. As I said, I need to go back and check out these older movies now because that looks great.